I started the One Care Foundation in 2009 after an internship that I did here in 2008. At that time, the center was going through a really rough time. I started it because I saw the potential of the center, but also especially the needs of the center. One Care Foundation is involved with all daily operations of the rescue program of Chikunanga Wildlife Center. We are taking care of 350 wild animals, protected and not protected. For example, bears, orangutans, gibbons, cassowaries, raptor species, but also all kinds of reptiles, so like turtles, crocodiles, snakes, all animals like that. They came from the illegal trade, what is a big problem here in Indonesia.
The problem that we are seeing over the last years, and that's becoming bigger and bigger, is illegal trade. And an example is the baby primates trade. So the mother gets shot in the wild, they take the baby. It's easy to take small primates and get them out of the country. And that's normally done by local poachers who make some money off it. But actually the large international criminal organizations are the ones that are making real money off it. They've been exported all over the world and they are in use like pets, and they are also going to the tourism industry. But for example, also they use bones for medicine. Another problem that we're seeing is, of course, habitat loss. There's a lot of deforestation going on, and of course, animals need a place to live. We see with, for example, gibbons and leopards that a lot of animals are just not finding enough food in their habitat, and they are searching for food in villages. So human-animal conflicts are increasing.
After the confiscation of an animal, it arrives here in Chikunanga, and the first thing we do is giving it medical care. Most of the time they are neglected, wounded, they have bullets in their bodies, are very weak, so they need first the medical care. And we make sure that they have no diseases, so we test them on diseases. After that, we bring them to the rehabilitation enclosures. Here the real rehabilitation starts, with the purpose, of course, that we release them in the end back to the wild. We work here with a team of foreign volunteers, but also internship students and the local people. So we have a vet, a security, cleaning lady, managers and animal keepers.
I work here since 2001 and maybe now about 16 years. And my activity, first prepare the food and then cleaning the cage and also checking the animal. It was a good or bad condition. Sometimes I help at clinic, and then also moving the animal from like from quarantine to other place.
An example of animals that we have here are Femi and Rosie, our baby orangutans. They were both confiscated. Femi was found in a bus station in Jakarta. She was found in a post package. The people on the bus station really saw the package moving, and that's how they discovered Femi. Happily, they could trace back the address and in that way the trader. And at the trader in Sumatra, they found four other baby orangutans. So after the confiscation, they came here. So we are taking care of them now. Every day we go outside with them to let them play in the forest, and here they learn how to climb the trees and which plants they can eat and everything. But we are now also trying to translocate them to a specialized rehabilitation center, specialized for orangutans. Here they will get in a baby group, and they learn from other orangutans how to survive in the wild. This process takes most of the time about 6 years before they can be released, but at least these two will be released in the future back to their natural habitat. Unfortunately, we also have animals that cannot be released, like Black and James here. James was held as a pet on a rubbish place on a short chain, and he was really mistreated by the owner, and he was giving him beer and cigarettes. Mentally, also, James is totally crazy, I can say. It's sad to say, but it's really true. So he is one of the monkeys that we cannot release. Another example is Siamang Black. Black came from an illegal zoo. And Black came in here in a really, really bad shape. He was very skinny, he had scabies all over his body, what is very itchy, so he was scratching the whole time, so he had no nails anymore, and he was full with parasites. Also, unfortunately, what you see quite a lot with primates and other animals actually as well. His canines are cut as well, so this means we cannot release him back to the wild. Although, for example, James and Black cannot be released back to the wild, we give them a lifetime care, so that means they will stay here the rest of their lives. And we try to do in the best possible way. So this means good enclosures, everyday enrichment to keep them busy, good food, but also, if possible, a company, so a friend where they can play with.
There are many animals in Chikenanga that actually have the potential to be released. For example, behind me are 6 Javan leopards, and considering that numbers are declining rapidly, something needs to be done. We have been developing a program especially for the Javan leopards. First, we're gonna start with building a rehabilitation enclosure, and that's one of the many steps that needs to be taken in the coming years to make sure that the Javan leopard doesn't become extinct. There are many things that we are really proud of. Since 2009, the Warnicare Foundation has made a real big difference here in Chikenanga. There has been a major difference in animal welfare over the last years. For example, we have been building a lot of new, better and more spacious enclosures, but also we have made strong progress with our day-to-day care. We do that with our local staff. They are very loyal, and also many volunteers that have been coming here. They make a real difference in achieving our goals. We've rescued many animals in recent years. We have now 350 animals here in Chikenanga, and we give them the best care, and we also prepare for releases. Something that we have done in the past and we were really willing to do in the future. Another thing that we are really proud of are the release programs that we developed in recent years. One example is the raptor release program. All the eagles that come in from illegal trade are part of this program. Step by step, we're going to try to rehabilitate them, and they go to bigger enclosures. We keep a close eye on them to make sure that they maybe can fly out someday. The last step where they go is actually the pre-release cage before they go to the remote release area where they really can fly out. We can only do the work with your help. For example, you can be a volunteer or you can do an internship here in Chikenanga. Also, we receive schools here for a multi-day program. Next to that, we are in need of medical supplies, and also we can use enrichment materials. We have this listed on our website. Warnicare runs only on donations, and we can do so much work for the animals that are in need of help, that have become victim of illegal trade or deforestation. If you believe that you can make a difference by helping us and you believe in our work, please contact us or donate right away.